Hello and welcome back to Unconventional Methods. Today I'm doing a photo shoot with my friend Ashley. We are going to be making a dress out of a shower curtain. Yes, you heard that right, a shower curtain. Whenever I do these draped fabric pieces, it never looks like it did when I tried it on at home. I think it came out pretty well. I could not for the life of me figure out how I had draped it at home, but seeing it on another person is always a different experience. Anyways, I think it came out really well. It's a textured, funky shower curtain. I just clipped it together. I got this corset top thing that I cut off an old prom dress. I used it as a layering piece. I was looking at it, deciding I really didn't like it just top and bottom, so I decided we needed to pull some fabric through the bottom to add some some teal to the top of it as well, so it's not just so separated and cut off. Ended up with a little bit more orange in the outfit than I actually wanted. She was doing orange makeup to go with the teal. And I found the orange corset top in my collection, and I was like, okay, that should work, but it's a little overwhelmingly orange. It's still pretty, it's just not exactly what I had in mind. Here I'm doing a lighting test. I am using the AD100 Pro from Godox. It is bare bulb. I'm not using a diffuser or anything on it because I want that punchy, in-your-face flash look. The camera I'm using is the Canon Powershot g5x, and I'm using dumb flash triggers. It's a single pin flash trigger. It is a leap shutter camera, so for some reason the compatibility with the TTL trigger, it just caps it at 1/250th or turns it into high speed sync, and it's a leaf shutter camera. You don't need high speed sync, so I just use the single pin trigger to override that feature. Shooting at the lowest ISO, which is 125 on this camera, and the aperture is set to f2.8, and the shutter is somewhere around 1/1600th. I believe the maximum shutter speed on this camera is 1/2000th, but it does have a built-in energy density filter, so that's nice. I'm used to shooting on ultra-wide lenses when I do fashion shoots. This is a small change of pace, seeing as the focal length equivalent, the widest end is 24mm. This is another shoot where we didn't stay too super long because it is winter and it is cold. This is my first official photo shoot with this camera, and I actually really like how the photos came out. I will definitely continue to use it going forward. This is our final location. This is a spot right next to where we parked the car, so that was really nice. I really liked how the sky was reflected in the windows of the building, and it really added to the teal and orange effect. Thank you for sticking around and watching my video. I will see you in the next one. Also, maybe like and subscribe, because it takes a lot of energy to do these and I need some encouragement.